Literally, like, the doors burst open, you could feel the wind hit your face. It was like Debbie Allen's here.
Amazing.
And she has her dancers, like one of them being Travis Payne.
And then it was a dance battle?
And then you guys it was sort of like a dance battle. We didn't win.
Welcome back to Dance Dish, where the dance ends and the dish begins. I'm your guest host, Diane Mizoda, and today I'm joined by Lisa Ratson,
hi,
Sebastian Lacaze, and Scott Fowler,
hey,
who's about to thread the needle with Michael Jackson, Tina Turner, Debbie Allen, all in one story.
Can you believe
story?
That? Three, like, icons?
Yeah.
That's incredible.
That's
crazy.
So
how
where
do you
did
think
it start?
They all fit together?
I don't know, but I'm
don't
really
know.
Interested.
Yes. I can't wait.
So it's 1995, and I'm a dancer in New York City, and Michael Jackson has decided to make a comeback and do a show live from the Beacon Theater, which is on the Upper West Side. So it's a really big deal. Amazing cast, and Lori Warner is in it.
Oh my gosh.
An icon.
Diva.
Icon. Diva dancer.
Yeah.
And a bunch of other dancers, and we're learning this really cool Clockwork Orange version of Bad, and everything seems to be going great, and we're about to meet Michael Jackson, and this was the first time, by the way, I had to get a flu shot before I met a celebrity.
What?
Wow.
Interesting.
A flu shot?
We all got flu shots, and we all got B12 shots. Oh. And
well,
then
that's
we were
fun.
Allowed to meet Michael Jackson, which was an
with
incredible.
With a flu shot?
With a flu shot,
that's
just
crazy.
To be safe.
I've never heard that
you
before.
Know, he was thinking what? Ahead.
Yes, right. He was ahead of his time.
Ahead of his time, pre-pandemic.
Oh, my God.
And mask.
So rehearsals are going great.
Gloves.
And we're gloves.
Just the one glove. You do have to pick things up.
Just the one glove. Rehearsals are going great. And Michael shows up, which, you know, hello, you're in the room with Michael Jackson, and it's incredible. And he's watching what we're doing, and you can tell that he's not quite thrilled. So about 3 weeks into rehearsal, these double doors like swoosh open and in comes Miss Debbie Allen with her fur coat on and all her dancers behind
she's like, you want fame.
Her shoulder.
Well, fame costs.
Right here is where you start paying.
And honey, I got all my dancers so the rest of you can have a seat over there, stage left.
Oh God, that would have made me cry.
I can't.
Exactly. So she starts rehearsing the show and there's like a double cast, so she doesn't need all of us. So many of us are sitting every day while they're rehearsing and creating this sort of new version of the show.
Scandalous. Wow.
And I'm like, all right, we're still getting paid. And then the phone rings, my phone. And I answer it, and Jerry
Wait, your
Mitchell.
Cell phone?
You don't have no cell phone.
No. Your phone
no
at home. Phone. You were at home.
Maybe
your
the
phone
pager.
Rang.
And at my answering
pager?
Machine.
Pager?
Pager, I said, hold on a second. I have another call coming in.
And on the answering machine is a choreographer named Jerry Mitchell, who was just starting
Legend.
Out at the time.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
May I say, and now he's a huge icon as well. And he said, listen, the VH1 Fashion Awards are happening this week, and Tina Turner is gonna sing Goldeneye, which was the new hit song from the James Bond movie. Do you wanna do it? No audition, just do you wanna do it?
And those I was are the like, best calls.
Those yes. are the best calls.
They are the best.
They were the best calls.
They don't they happen.
They
were any, the best.
They don't happen anymore.
So I was like, okay, well, I'm here doing dancing. I'm sort of dancing for Michael Jackson, not really because I'm just sitting around. But I would love to do this with Tina Turner. So, you know, I mean, at this point, what do you do, right?
What would you ask?
You put your big boy pants on and you go to the stage manager and you say, listen, Tina Turner just called and wants me to like dance for the VH1 Fashion Awards. And Jerry Mitchell's gonna choreograph it. And since I'm just sitting here, do you mind if I go do that?
And they said, yes, we mind. Sit back down. Did they say that?
No, they said, yes, you can go. And yes, we'll still pay you because
what? Amazing.
Yeah, so girl, I was double booking.
Like
double
booking.
Wow, that's only
never.
Something. That's
only
so Scott Fowler.
Scott Fowler.
That is so that is like Scott Fowler.
That is exactly. Super Scott Fowler.
Yes,
and then the end of the story is I'm doing the VH1 Fashion Awards downtown with Tina Turner, and Michael Jackson is supposedly doing this show at the Beacon Theater live, and he, as we all know, or do you remember, sprained his ankle. And so that show never happened.
Oh, wow. So you
perfect
made the
decision.
Right choice.
Well, I made the best choice because I got paid for that gig that never happened. Yeah. And then I danced with Tina Turner and GoldenEye. People always say to me, who are the best three you've ever worked with? Being who are the biggest stars you've ever worked with? And Tina Turner is definitely one of them. Cher is second. Or actually, they're all the same. Cher, Tina Turner, and...
In case Cher's watching, you don't want to hurt her feelings.
I don't want to hurt Cher's feelings. Whoopi Goldberg.
Oh my gosh. Aww, I have amazing. Like connections to like almost every person you said. Just really quickly, like did the same song, GoldenEye, with Tina Turner on the Billboard Awards though. And then worked with Debbie on the Oscars.
And congratulations, Debbie Allen, being honored by the Kennedy Center Honors, finally. Yes, congratulations.
Oh wow, that's amazing.
Debbie.
Yeah, that's long overdue. Yeah. Oh, Cher.
Cher.
Cher, like, I just moved to LA. Remember the guy named Aaron, with like the long blonde hair?
Aaron Cash.
Aaron Cash.
Aaron Cash.
Aaron
Cash.
Remember
they were
Aaron
replacing.
Cash.
Remember Aaron
How could
Cash?
We not?
Yeah,
they were replacing Aaron Cash. So they had a big audition, and I booked it. And then they were like, remember when we called you and cast you in that show and you were gonna be the one? Yeah, we're not doing that anymore.
Oh, it didn't work out for you.
It didn't work out for me.
Well, this worked out for me. And that was a great show.
I was just doing the opposite.
One story worked out.
I was doing the opposite.
One story did not work out, Mr. Ashton, because
the
opposite happens for me.
Yeah,
I was like,
there's that, there's Scott Fowler.
I mean, but no, really, listen. How many times does it not work out? And you're trying to, you know, we juggle. We're trying to juggle gigs and make them all work. And then sometimes, you know, this worked out great where I still got the paycheck for Michael.
Well, but maybe you have many jobs that you have to juggle. That's why you have to juggle the jobs. I haven't had many jobs to juggle.
That's
not true, Lisa.
You have many jobs to juggle.
Okay, sometimes.
It is about juggling.
Juggling jobs. Let's toast to juggling jobs.
To juggling jobs.
Juggling
jobs.
Jobs.
And to Dance Dish.
To Dance Dish. Dance Dish. Dance Dish. Dance Dish. Work it, kids. 5, 6, 7, 8.